Welcome back to Let's Play Scratch's Director's Cut. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari, up here on the third floor now of this creepy old mansion. Still exploring. So can we look out the window or anything? No, okay. Huh. The door seemed to be stuck. I don't suppose we have anything in our inventory that could help with that. It's stuck, not locked. No, I could have hurt myself. I didn't have a need to write on that. It's stuck, not locked. Key didn't fit there. That wasn't useful. Okay then. Be that way. Don't open. See if I care. Hello? Wow. Worst bathroom ever. It was just a pile of old bricks. What's that? What did I get? An Allen key? It was a small metal rod that I found in the upper bathroom. Huh. Maybe that can be used to get through that door. Well, we'll finish exploring this first. Are these electrical? Oh yeah, wires, yeah. Well, the electricity's not on anyway. Before I move forward, anything over here to look at? Boxes, but we don't care. Okay. The upper bathroom would have been beautiful under different conditions, but in its current state, it was sad and depressing. Most of the planks scattered throughout the third floor were all dry and brittle by now. Well, they never finished constructing this bathroom, apparently. Or remodeling it, or whatever was going on. To the connecting room. Oh, God. I'm sorry, guys. I can't. I'm out the window. Yeah, whoom. Okay. Anything to look at before we move forward without going into endless death spiral? The amount of trash in this room was unbelievable. Well, it's construction materials. I swore that I would scream if I saw another brick. We really hate bricks that much? I don't even want to imagine the piles of rubbish that were inside those boxes. Can't take the broom. We could tidy the place up. I mean, it's not just trash. They were, you know, fixing the place up. Never finished. A neat little stove was standing on a plank. I had to light the stove first. We do have matches. Let me quick save before I do that, because I don't want to waste a match. I don't have a reason to light this. I'm no pyromaniac. Since I had no intention of burning anything just yet, I decided not to waste any matches. Good man. And I've looked here, right? Yeah. So is this the door we came through? I think so. Uh Alright, so then this goes back out into the hallway. This is the other door. Right, and then we got stairs, and we continue that way. Whoops. Hold on. I want to see if that rod could help us unstick the door here. That was pointless. Okay. Under construction. Most of the planks scattered throughout the third floor are all dry and brittle by now. Yeah. Anything of interest? They were just some uninteresting boxes. Well, they're uninteresting on the outside, but who knows what might be inside them. Silly man. Well, we've got two sets of stairs going up. We've got this and we've got that one. Oh, and I missed a door here. Is this another door into that same room? The door was locked, but I could see a key on the other side through the keyhole. I mean, this would just push the key out. That was pointless. I had to have some means of retrieving the key. There was quite a bit of light coming from below the door. Can we perhaps push the key out and then scoop it from the other side? Like, scoop it from this side through the... I mean... We see light, but I don't know how much, if you can push something through there. You could hurt yourself. Made the stethoscope, right? I couldn't hear anything out of the ordinary. Really? We can use a stethoscope to hear through things? Okay. I find that unsettling. We can use the stethoscope to hear things. Mmm. What are we going to hear, I wonder? It was clean enough. Because if we put something under the door, right, and then knock the key out, like a sheet of paper or something, and then we knock the key out, but then we can pull the sheet of paper through. But I don't know if there's a gap on this side. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's something else we have to find that would help us do that, that we haven't found yet. I feel like going up these stairs first. Huh, just a single room door type thing. Still no power. There's nothing of interest among these trinkets. Except for this. This trinket. What is this? Oh! It's spooky as hell. Okay, done with that. I thought we could take this out and use it to push the key. That's attached. That's backwards. That's like a mirror. There's something... news. Something ah news. A useless array of random items of every imaginable size and color occupied all the corners of the attic. I mean, you've got a stroller, you've got a mannequin type thing, sort of. Photograph. Spilled paint. Mirror. I couldn't see clearly enough to identify the objects in that dark area. Or if we could light this candle. No pyromaniac. Now we can see Gaiety. Picture Drome. Get the advantage, join our circle of satisfied patrons, see the best super pictures. Meat Packers Limited, wholesale meats. Beef, lamb, veal, pork. 3 meat cuttings. Address, Blackwood. Complete player rosters. Here's our team. University of Southern California and University of Washington. Okay, an aircraft tuning up something plane. Come something aeroplane. Burnt by the fire. New Zealand. Hastings Street. Program? This is like an opera ballot sheet kind of thing, if I'm using the right terminology. Barrow, 1848. Something school of something. Charred? Charred ruins this morning after something blaze. Meeting place for young artists since its reestablishment as a design school in 1903. The building is considered a total loss. Its roof caved in, walls charred and seared, and windows smashed. Blackened by flames. I don't know, it says Swain School of something. A postcard and then okay. The pile of newspapers was huge. I needed a more specific date to search for. Really? How do we let the game know what date we want? I mean, do we want to read more about the school? See, this is burned. We have a lot of pictures of burned things. ...1903. But I can't input a date here. Hmm. There's nothing of interest among those trinkets. I strained my eyes to detect if there was anything useful among that junk, but instead I get the impression of a sinister presence lurking in the shadows. In that small area? A sinister presence? The old-fashioned lamp made me think of exciting adventures I've always dreamed of going on. Well, before we go there, let's look over here. There's nothing much to see, huh? No. Okay. Sinister presence. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Alright, let's illuminate. The lamp didn't have any oil in it. Oh, okay. Let us not illuminate. Lamp oil. I don't know why I wanted to look at that window. Well, there's one place we haven't gone, besides the basement. Up here. And I mean places we could possibly go. I didn't even try the key on that basement door. I really don't want to go down there. Well, we go up even further, and then there's this door. Well, that's a window. We're gonna have to run out there at some point to escape something. Oh wow. We have bats in our belfry. A couple of old and rusty lamps adorn the top of the tower. Not a pyromaniac. There's a large crack in one of the walls in the tower. So I see. Jump to our doom! Might mess around with the crack. Just want to check his journal. So I've read all this. Feel free to pause the video if you want to read it. Perfect. The room that Jerry ordered to be prepared for me has to have the best spot in the whole house, with a huge window overlooking the garden. The view is breathtaking and inspiring, and is bound to permit me to concentrate on my work. I should probably start working right away, but I'm really dying to explore the place. That's a way of putting things. Was pointless. It's a clean crack. Now this is what again? A boring tool. Okay. Yeah, I don't see anything else we can mess with. We need lamp oil to explore the rest of the attic with the foreboding presence. We need a way to get See, there's another crack. We need a way to get inside this door here. We missed something in the room on the second floor. The other bedroom that isn't ours. And we've yet to go into the basement. Now I think the basement's off from the kitchen? Well, that's the library. The kitchen's not through there. Didn't fit there. Maybe in that bedroom we can get lamp oil. It said I missed something. I just have no idea what it is that we would have missed. This is the museum type place. This is the bedroom, I think. So I'm looking at lamps. Well, these are all electrical lamps. And there's this thing that's killing me with the mirror. That might have to do with what we've missed. Can't seem to move this. I wonder if there's anything behind it. He doesn't want to look at anything over there. And the broken frame here. We can open that, but we can't take it. Can't actually grab this stuff. Doesn't it look like it could be lamp oil? Or medicine? Wonder if he says it again. Yep. I had a curious feeling of having missed something. Here's our bedroom. Just looking around for lamp oil right now. The view is inspiring. Joey had picked the right room for me. It would be ideal when doing some work. I may or may not have read that. Where would I find lamp oil? These are like for candles, but we don't have candles. Did we look in these drawers here? I know, this isn't the room in which we've missed something. Oh, we put our suitcase down there. Didn't notice that. That I've looked at. Oh, we did not look in here. So this is where the doctor was staying. Is it James? So it makes sense. He's studying anatomy. Are those tendons? I wish I could read what it says. Proof spirit. Strong stuff. Empty. And there's nothing on the other side that can be opened. Okay. Disturbing letter in the waste bin. Oh, little bit he wrote. The ending. Have to come up with a suitable ending. The final twist was the most celebrated aspect of VT. They will, a vanished town, right? They will tear me apart if I don't pull off another thing like that. But how? I'm up to the point where Steve goes mad. She is confused. Okay, Steve is a she. So now we know the visions are becoming real. So now we know for sure there's a supernatural element in the story. Wait, is that really so? Question is, does it have anything to do with the creepy old lady or not? Would it be too obvious if her powers were real after all? Big, big question. Would people accept it if the solution to the story is unreal? Damn, why am I trying to please everybody here? No something. No deus ex machina. On the other hand, a realistic solution disguised as supernatural. Is that possible? They're expecting something like that. A real and probable outcome. That's what they loved in VT. Bloody hell, this is driving me insane. I don't think I looked in here. The practical photographer. Not lamp oil, I guess. We got a pencil. Okay. Picture of the outside. It was an old picture of the kitchen that I had just left. As for that vase, it definitely rang a bell. Well, I noticed there is a key hanging here. Is it giving me a hint? Is the key in the vase? Maybe it fell. Or it was moved. Anything else I might have missed in here? I did look in here. think I looked at that. I did look at that. I looked at these. It was just some useless junk. Yeah, I've looked in here. So maybe we need to look in that pot for the key, and that would be to the basement? Which I'm not looking forward to. The pot's not there. Looks like blood there, doesn't it? It does say underneath the key holder, right? Where's the pot? I've seen the pot. Though the pot was moved. I didn't realize there's no pot there either. It's not one of these, is it? Step forward. These are not pots. Well, not that kind of pot. Back in that room. That pot? Well, I can't look at that pot, can I? That looks like a smaller one anyway. Oops. Ah, we're stuck. Okay. I didn't look. The pencil was very ordinary. Where did we find that? Picture of the room. Did I just take the picture? That's a pail. Not sure. Well, the pot's been moved? To where? Ah! Got it. The rusty golden key was quite heavy. Well, I guess as far as keys go. Golden key fit nicely into place and unlocked the door. Yeah, I like the sound of that. Old Town Hall, Parade of Stars, each and every night, Paul Clement Trio. Marilyn Green, Danny Crystal, Gala Night every Monday. Broadcast. Come and join the fun. Old Town Hall. The only returns by rounds from the Jeffrey Sharkey battle will be received by special wire this evening at the St. James Motel. Arrangements having been made with the Postal Telegraph Company, the only authentic returns from the ringside. That's very distracting. Whoops, I'm stuck. Stuck. Ugh. Cook's conducted tours. British Seagull, the best overlooked motor in the world. Terribly cold and damp in the basement and creepy. Oh, can we switch them? There appear to be nothing wrong with the fuses. Okay then. Mrs. Winslow's soothing syrup. Yeah, I could use a little soothing right now. There are just some uninteresting boxes. Oh, look at these old style. Yeah, I guess that's UK fixtures. Receptacles. There was a huge furnace covering most of the east wall. I didn't understand why, but I began to feel terribly uneasy. It had a menacing look to it. My mind could have been playing tricks on me, but there seemed to be some occasional distant noises. As long as they're distant and not close by. This way a little quieter over here. There was a drain cover in the concrete. The valve was stuck and wouldn't budge. What can we do with the drain cover? I hoped I wouldn't have to push any of these boxes around. Suddenly I feel a very cold breeze on my neck, and it's then that I realize I wanted to leave the basement as soon as possible. Okay. I don't think there's anything else to see down here. Well, if I can turn to get to the stairs, I'll leave as soon as possible. Where's the door? Alright, so we got in there. We realize we can't turn this on. Can't turn the power on. I wonder if we can make a call to Jerry. Now that we've seen the number. He was complaining before they didn't see his number. I want to speak with Jerry.
Hello?
Jerry, it's me.
What's up, Michael?
Everything seems to be fine, except the lights don't work.
Oh, you don't have to worry. I forgot to tell you. I had an electrician, one that I trust, to meet you there this morning. You know how a lack of power can be a recurring issue in old places like that. He should be arriving soon.
That's good to know. I'll set up my stuff and let you know how everything does later.
Perfect. Have fun. And don't forget to stop by the gates to meet that guy.
Sure.
Oh, okay. I guess that may be the next thing we should do. He didn't say when he's coming. I mean, we can keep track of time. I called Barbara. Numbers. Huh.
Hello, Arthate Productions.
Arthate Productions? What in heaven's name was that?
Oh, hi, boss. I was just fooling around.
Well, don't. I don't want people thinking I'm some kind of studio. And don't call me boss.
I'm sorry, it's just that no one was calling and all of a sudden I got excited.
I told you it was going to be that way, girl. But I still need you there. I just hope you're not being bored to death.
Oh, don't worry. I'm studying tongues during my spare time. I love that so much.
That's great, but don't lower your guard. As soon as I publish my new book, that place is going to get riddled with phone calls and hundreds of fan mail.
That's the spirit, boss. I know your new book is going to be a huge success.
Of course it will. As soon as I find a proper ending. And stop calling me boss.
As you wish, boss. Oh, sorry.
Thanks. Goodbye.
Good luck.
Good luck, boss. I called another number? Oh, we can manually dial. This should be operator. Alright, never mind. Alright. So I'm wondering if I should meet this electrician at the gate. I'm gonna save that for next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.